Hi guys, in today's session we will see how to create a digital certificate or digital SSL certificate. Also it is recognized one, not self-signed certificate, so we'll need to install a cert board using the command as seen in screen. So this certificate will be 3 months renewable, and we need to ensure that HTTPS port or secure port, port number 443, or which is not specific, any port can be secure port, that need to be from the browser, and it can be securely connected, and there is no warning or error message for the browser that it is coming just like it is coming from a trusted source. So we'll use for this purpose the Letsencrypt organization, which is donation based organization, and they are giving 3 months certificate for your web server to connect through SSL. So we are just checking what sites are enabled, and in the Apache web server itself. This is very necessary because this becomes, this port is more secure if we assign a certificate to our site. So here we are disabling default site, and then we are reloading the configurations to Apache web server through sudo systemctl reload Apache 2 command, and then we'll restart the Apache server in order for changes to take place. And this is our PostgreSQL connected via pgadmin. See here, the it is showing not secure site. We need to avoid this thing, and so that it should show the secure port, and the communication is also encrypted. Right now the page is still loading. So it has not been connected. Let's check HTTPS port. So it's coming, but it's showing it is not secure so far. We'll clear the screen, and then we'll issue the command Apache 2 CTL config test to check our certificate is working or not. And it's showing that syntax is okay. So the firewall status need to be checked as well. Here we can see ports 443 and 22 are enabled, and 22 is for this secure shell SSH, and 443 is for HTTPS through browser. So we need to allow here Apache full. We need to delete the allow Apache, and which is not an existing rule as it is. So the status is Apache full is now allowed here, then we can issue the command such as cert boot and Apache with the Apache switch. Now it is asking to enter the domain name, as there were no names found by the command. So the domain names need to be entered comma separated. So our fully qualified domain name I will enter here. Basically, it is a website and I have created a subdomain there, which is targeting to the public IP address. So it is obtaining a new certificate and enabled Apache rewrite module cleanup challenges and able to find a virtual host listing on port 80, which is currently needed for cert boot to prove to the CA that you control your domain. Please add a virtual host for port 80. So the virtual host which we disabled previously need to be enabled for this certificate to work. For this reason, we'll enable the default port, and we'll also need to reload the configurations or virtual host configurations once we have disabled. We have enabled the site, and then we need to restart the Apache web server. Once the Apache web server is restarted, then we need to issue the command to again for cert boot. So that there is no error anymore. We need to just check the configuration file for default port of 80 about this virtual host. So we will use the nano editor here, and this we have to type a server name. This will be a fully qualified server name. Also, server alias need to be www.digitalvision.pkrashti.com. It also need to be entered. We need to do the indentation. Okay, then we need to save the file. Then we need to reload the configuration. Although it was not necessary, we need to restart Apache server in order for configuration to take place. And then we need to issue the cert boot command with Apache switch again. And now it is picking the domain name easily. And it is asking which one need to be activated for HTTPS. So both domain names are available. So I will just enter, and it will select the both of the domains. But here the challenge has failed for www. Actually, there is no mapping for www from my domain. That's why it has failed this one. Let's again start, and this time again it is failing for the www domain, and let's opt for only one first one, and which is option one here. Instead we need to input the option number in itself, not a domain name. So I'll input one, which it will find the mapping from my domain or subdomain from host getter to the public IP address, and now it is waiting for verification. Hopefully it will work. Still it is not working somehow. Let's see what are the reasons. Yeah, it is basically firewall which is blocking the port. I have added now the rule for 80 port because it was disabled. So I will check the status. Now 80 port is also allowed, and I will start again. And again I will select the option one. Ideally it should work now. Yes, it is now working. So it's giving me two options: no redirect, make no further changes to the web server. And if I need a redirect, I've selected no redirect. I've selected the redirect option. Okay, now now see, there is warning has gone because now certificate is working. Certificate is working, and you know, it has picked up the certificate. Also for PG admin, now it is not unsecure. It is without any warning. So it is showing me that certificate is already set up, and it has also saved it. So the status assert board timer I need to check. So it will run assert board twice daily, and it's showing the status is active. Okay, so timer is working fine, and I also need to test the renewal thing whether it will work or not. So whenever the certificate is after 3 months it is ready for renewal, it will automatically check using the timer, and it will update. So this is how you need to add the certificate to your site. Free of cost, and the only thing is it is valid for 3 months, and then it will auto renew. Thank you very much for watching the video, and subscribe to my channel for watching more of informative video such as this one. Thank you very much, guys.